As someone who is very budget conscious, there actually were a few things that we decided to splurge on when we had a baby. So today I'm sharing the baby item splurges that were totally worth it. Hey guys, I'm Marissa and welcome back to my channel. Here on my channel, we talk about motherhood and money and how you can enjoy life while still accomplishing financial goals through the use of a budget. So if that sounds like something interesting to you, then scroll down and hit that subscribe button so you won't miss any new videos. So if you know that I'm a fan of budgeting, then you may probably think that it's crazy that I would say that I would even splurge money on something. But this is what I love about budgeting. Having a budget doesn't mean that you're poor or that you can't spend money. It's not restrictive. A budget is simply a plan for your finances, and I love being able to use a budget so that we can keep track of all of our income, our expenses, look towards our savings goals and other financial goals that we're working on. And a budget just helps us to keep it all in check. And therefore, I use my budget all the time to be able to allow myself the permission to spend because I've planned for it in my budget. I am a new mom. My son Peter is 10 months old now, and we decided to splurge on a few things when he was born. And so now that he's 10 months old, I wanted to sit down and share with you some of these splurges that I think were totally worth it. Also, I will have links to all of these splurge items in the description box below so you can check them out there. And I also want to let you know, if you are expecting to have a baby soon, I actually have a course called Budgeting for Baby, all about what it's called, which is budgeting and planning your finances for having a baby. It walks you through all the things that you need to know for preparing your budget, expenses that you can expect, how to navigate medical costs and what that'll all entail, and basically anything that has to do with money and having a baby, we talk about in this course. So I will leave a link to that down below in the description box, and you can check it out there and join me for my budgeting for baby class. So let's talk about those splurges. The first one being Love Every Toys. And I've shared about that many times on my channel because we genuinely do love their toys. But if you don't know what Love Every is, it's a play kit subscription company that sends toys that are perfect for your child's age and development. When your child is from 0 to 12 months, the boxes come every other month, and then their play kits actually go up to age 3. And we have loved using their toys. They are Montessori inspired, really high quality, made with organic materials, and they encourage development for your child. I love that it just takes the guesswork out of trying to figure out what my baby needs at each stage and what's going to be like the best kind of toy for them. So we love Every Toys. They're also super cute. Love Every Toys are $80 per box, and that comes every other month, so it's kind of like $40 a month, which at first I was like, oh gosh, like maybe that seems like a lot. But I actually recently did a video breaking down the cost of Love Every Toys. I'll leave a link to it up above here so you can check it out. But honestly, it's basically the same cost if you were to buy all these other toys individually, and instead it just gets sent to you and takes the hassle out of trying to figure out what your baby needs. So I would highly recommend Love Every. I have an affiliate link to them down in the description box below where you can check them out. But again, we love their toys. I think it was totally worth the splurge. My next splurge is our stroller system, which is the Upa Baby Vista. So I actually really wanted this stroller when I was pregnant, and this was one of the things that I decided I wanted to splurge on. And honestly, it is not disappointed. Since I am a pandemic mom, my son was born in May 2020. It was absolutely crazy. But basically the only thing that we've been able to do has been going on walks. And we go on lots of walks around the neighborhood. I'm still looking forward to spring and summer for us to go on more walks. But the Vista has been absolutely perfect and totally worth the splurge. The Upa Baby Vista is about $970, which is a hefty price tag, but honestly, I feel like it's been worth it. I recently did a video talking about how I decide to splurge on something, so I'll leave a link to that up above. But one of the criteria for wanting to splurge on something is knowing that it's going to last a long time, and that's what I felt like was the reasoning for getting the Vista. Because the Vista stroller can actually convert from a single stroller to a double stroller, so I knew that I'd be using the stroller for several years between two kids, and it was something that I only needed to buy once and wouldn't have to worry about anything else. Whereas I feel like so many times we often buy like a cheaper version of something and then end up having to buy it twice because it breaks, or then you realize that you actually wanted something else, so then you have to buy something else. So I've heard this motto and I'm gonna live by it too, which is buy nice or buy twice. And I feel like that was definitely the case with getting the Upa Baby Vista. Do you need it? No, but I love the design of it. It's so sleek. I love that the seats turn either way. I can clip, I have the Up a Baby Mesa car seat and just clips into the stroller. I love the whole system. And the fact that whenever we have a second baby, it'll easily convert to a double is huge. And again, we use it like every day because I love being able to take my son for walks in it. So I think that that's definitely been worth the splurge. The other thing that I will say when it comes to splurging money on something, I still love to be able to find little ways to save money. So with the Up a Baby Vista, I actually was able to save money because I bought it when they were getting rid of last year's model. So last year's model was on sale. I also then paired it with my completion coupon discount that I had with my baby registry at Buy My Baby. So I actually paid like a little over $600 on the thing, but I saved a few hundred dollars on the overall price of the Up a Baby Vista. So even though I like to splurge, I still like to find ways to save. It like gives me this like saver's high, you know? I would love it. So I think that the Up a Baby Vista was definitely worth the price. And once we have a second baby, all I'll need to do is buy like the additional rumble seat for it, and then it'll be good to go for many more years with more children. The next few splurges that I have are pretty much all sleep related because, you guys, sleep is so important, and I feel like I would definitely splurge so that my baby could get sleep, so that I could get sleep, and we could all be happier people. I feel like that's worth a splurge. So the first sleep related thing is the Owlet. The Owlet is a smart sock monitor that you put on baby's foot, and it monitors their heart rate and oxygen levels. And it is being sold for $300, which is definitely not cheap. But for me, I felt like it gave me such peace of mind, like having this device and knowing that like Peter was doing okay while he was sleeping. It would then alarm you if their oxygen or heart rate levels dipped below like what it should be. So that was just something that gave me peace of mind and helped me to be able to sleep. And so Peter still wears it every single night, and I love the thing. It also actually tracks like when baby falls asleep. You can see like how long they slept for, which is helpful also for determining like wake windows and things like that. The awesome benefit to the Owlet, and another way that you can save money on it, is that it is HSA and FSA eligible. Then you can use those dollars to be able to purchase the Owlet, which is actually what we did with it. We had an HSA last year, and we used some of the funds there to buy the Owlet. It felt like it gave me that extra permission to spend because I had the HSA dollars sitting there, and it has a great tax benefit, so I was able to use that for the Owlet purchase. My next splurge is the Hatch sound machine, and this retails for $60. We love this thing. The Hatch sound machine has different sounds and also has different colors that you can have set up, and you can control it all from the app, which I really like having that added feature. Babies often do better with sleeping with having a sound machine because it helps drown out extra background noise, and babies are also just used to white noise when they sleep. Of like being in the womb is a very noisy environment, so having a sound machine has been key for us. Peter's used a sound machine every night since he's been born, and we love the Hatch. I feel like I was able to splurge on this as well because it was another piece that I know will last us for a very long time. I really love the feature with the Hatch sound machine because you can have it set up to like change color at a certain time. So I think that when Peter is like a toddler, preschooler, we can have the Hatch set up to like turn green at 7 a.m. And at that point, he knows that like, oh, okay, it's morning time, it's time to get up. But if it's not green, then like you still need to stay in your room, or, you know, still nighttime, go back to sleep, or play quietly, or like, I don't know, whatever that will entail. But I just love that it has these added features, and I know that we're going to use the Hatch for several years, so I felt like it was worth the splurge. The next thing that we splurged on that we were not planning to but did was the Snoo bassinet. And if you guys have been here for a little bit, then you know that I've talked many times about the Snoo, but I love this thing. The Snoo is quite expensive. It is $14.95 currently. They actually just recently increased the price, but I will say that it's worth it. I actually recently did a video talking all about the cost of the Snoo and how it's like worth the price. I did a whole cost breakdown and also ways that you can save money on it. So I'll leave a link to that video up above and you can check it out. But basically, the Snoo is a smart bassinet, and the way that it works is when you put baby in it in their special swaddles, it then lightly rocks them. So it's proven to help lengthen baby sleep 1 to 2 hours, which when I first had my son, I was like, 1 to 2 hours of sleep for $1,400. Like, there's no way, that's ridiculous. And then you have a baby and you're like, what I wouldn't give for 1 or 2 more hours of sleep. So we actually didn't have the Snoo for the first 6 weeks of Peter's life. And then we were like, we're doing it, we're splurging, we're getting the Snoo. And honestly, it was a total game changer when it came to Peter's sleep. He got sleep, we got sleep. I can't recommend the Snoo enough. We were able to find ways to save on it. It actually went on sale by the time that we purchased it, which was great. And like I said, check out the Snoo video because I talk all about ways that you can save money on it there. But it was definitely worth the splurge for us. And it's actually currently being used by some friends who had a baby because I wanted to be able to loan it out to the other people because we love it so much. The Snoo actually doesn't really fit my criteria of being something that you can use for a long time because you can only use it up to 6 months. And so that was another thing why I was so hesitant on spending so much money on it. But knowing the value of sleep really outweighed the fact that we could only use it for 6 months. Although we do plan to use it for the next however many kids we have, so that's another justification for it. The next sleep splurge is the Newton crib mattress. Now this mattress is $300, which is not cheap, but the amazing thing about the Newton crib mattress is that it is breathable, and I'm not kidding, it is completely breathable. Stick your face up to it, you can breathe like normal. So this was another thing that just gave me a lot of reassurance that Peter was going to be okay when he was like starting to sleep on his tummy. He now only sleeps on his tummy. And sometimes he sleeps with his face completely on the mattress like this. And just knowing that his mattress is breathable gives me a lot of reassurance. The actual mattress like core of the Newton is this like, looks like spaghetti strings basically. And it's, you know, completely breathable. And then the cover of the mattress is also breathable. And I'm kid you not, you put your face up to it and you can breathe through it just fine. So it's an amazing reassurance and it also seems really comfy. So I will say I actually previously did a partnership with Newton and they sent me this crib mattress. So I didn't actually pay for it out of my own pocket, but now that I have it, I totally understand that it would be justified with the cost because it's so awesome. Honestly, it's really great. The next thing is my cheapest splurge, and that is on the Nested Bean sleep sack. I really love this thing. This was perfect for when we moved Peter from his Snoo bassinet into the crib. And this is a sleep sack and it has like a little weighted thing on the chest and it just kind of feels like your hand is on their chest. So that was just like another way to help baby be soothed and go to sleep. So Peter loved this thing. When he was initially moved to the crib, he would sleep on his back and also sometimes he'd like roll to his side. So the Nested Bean was perfect. But now that he's a bit older, he actually loves to only sleep on his tummy, which the other thing about the Nested Bean, and this is another way we could use it for him, is that you can actually stick the weight on the back instead if you have a tummy sleeper. But I really think that this helped Peter with the transition from the Snoo to the crib. Just having that little extra bit of comfort with the Nested Bean sleep sack was really helpful. The Nested Bean is $35, so it's definitely a lot cheaper than the other things I've shared, but still is more of a splurged item being like a sleep sack. So those are some of the splurged baby items that we have that are honestly so worth it. Now that our son is 10 months old, I can say that they were worth it. So I will have links to all of these things down in the description box below and you can check them out there. Also, you can check out my budgeting for baby course in the description box if you are expecting a baby and want to learn more about finances and all the money things that go into pregnancy and having a baby. And with that, I will look forward to seeing you guys in my next video. Bye.